One of the very greatest challenges of leadership is for people to uncover and work on their strengths. And this is not easy. We often have situations in organizations and the culture of organizations that focus on what you are not, what your weaknesses are. Again, international research demonstrates it is understanding your own strengths and the strengths of others and leveraging on that.
USB is a place where we develop leaders who think. There's two components to that. We develop leaders. We're very concentrated upon the contribution to the personal development of MBA students, particularly in terms of their own leadership and indeed their contribution to following as well as leading.
The University of Stellenbosch Graduate Business School has recognized over a number of years that in looking at what's happening around South Africa, in Africa, and also globally, that the need for strong, effective, and I would also like to say positive leadership styles, I'd like to say something like ethical leadership, especially if you look at what's happening now. And of course, in South Africa, the whole area around transformational leadership. And when we identified all of these, we felt that this is one area, if we were to focus on it, it could really just become a major part of what we do with the MBA.
Perhaps the single most important thing about leadership is that good leaders are not born, they are developed. So people come with the potential. And at the USB MBA program, that's what we work with. It's not about changing who the individual is, but it's for the individual to reveal who they can be as a leader. The second most important thing is there's no golden formula for leadership. It's not about trying to clone yourself on someone else. It's discovering your personal strengths, your personal authenticity, and working on that, as well as uncovering those elements which you can enhance and expand upon to become the very best leader you can be.
The way we address the leadership module in the MBA is where we actually work with the students through four different phases of leadership. The first of this is personal leadership and emotional intelligence. And this is very intrapersonally. And then after that, we move to interpersonal leadership skills and group dynamics. And this is where, for the first time, the student gets to realize, I need to work interdependently, I've got other people in my world. But very soon, they also come to see, but wait a minute, I'm not going to be working on an island. I'm going to be working somewhere in an organization. And if I'm going to work in an organization, we then take them to the third area, and that is organizational leadership and people development, or as some refer to as human resource development. And the last part of what we do with them is that of societal and global leadership. And so these are the four areas that we cover through our leadership development process. I would like to refer prospective students to the logo that we have for the Center for Leadership Studies. And there are two aspects of the logo I would just like to emphasize at this point. The one is that we feel leaders who graduate from the Stellenbosch Business School should first of all be values-based. And then the second, vision-directed. And this is very well captured in the logo. Added to that, I think over the past number of years, we've been able to attract students from all over Africa as well as from all over the world. And one of the most exciting things to be part of the MBA program at USB is to actually sit in a class and maybe for some, for the very first time, interact with people whose thinking is maybe quite different from yours. Somebody coming from Brazil, or somebody who comes from Nigeria, or maybe somebody from Kenya. And there, for the first time, you have to ask yourself, have I really got the full picture? And you very soon realize that you don't. And so for us, things such as multiculturalism, the whole question of transformational leadership, the whole question of global leadership feeds very well into this perspective. as people climb the corporate ladder, the technical skills that originally brings you into the job market actually becomes of less importance. The things that become really important as you get to the top would be your emotional intelligence, your interpersonal relationship skills. I think of things such as your ability to form alliances. Now, once we start speaking like that, then quite obviously, it's all in the domain of leadership. And if we do not focus on leadership, we will get people sitting at the top that are technically highly qualified and very skilled, but not able to lead people.